Let's play some more Dungeon Hack. We had a slight snafu last time. Nothing that we can't handle, though. I went up to level 5 and got 9 hit points as a bonus. Then I closed the window accidentally, but I'm back at level 5. I only got 6 hit points instead of 9 this time. Sorry, I was just starting the music again. But it's okay. See, our hit point max is now 30. Which isn't bad. We're still on level 2. Hopefully we can finish this up before the end of this video. Should probably get my spells back, so I'm going to rest. Still doing pretty good on food. That food meter always cracked me up. I mean, I think of it as a hunger meter. It's like, when it's full, you're full. When it's empty, you're, on the verge of starving. But it doesn't say hunger, it says food. So it's like a meter measuring how much food is in your stomach as it's being digested. You might have missed it, but there's a message down here where it caught an illusionary wall as I was walking past. So after I kill these guys... Oops. Why did I do that? I want to go back and... Freaking zombies. Let's see. There we go. This wall seems funny somehow. Another maze that we probably won't need. Let's do detect magic, see if there's anything special about it. Oh, it is a magical maze. Just like this other one that we have. I don't need a rock. What am I holding on to that for? I guess I might... Oh, here's a journal page I haven't read yet. Only magical weapons can hurt gargoyles. I knew that, but thank you. Is that all that's back here? Looks like it. Okay. We can continue on the way we were going. Staff. Hey, a ring. Sweet. And a flail. I'm not sure if we can use that. Well, we can't use it in that hand. Another thing about the flame blade is once you cast it, you have to wait for it to wear off before you can use a hand. Which is kind of bogus, but... Well, let's see what this ring does. Well, it's not cursed. That's good. Doesn't affect any of our stats, it looks like. So it's another magical ring with no obvious effect. I hope I get a chance to identify those. There's nothing that bugs me more than having a magical item and me not having any idea what it does. Whoa. Freaking shadow already? It's crazy. A white potion. Well, that's new. And it is a potion of confusion. It should wear off pretty soon. Hey everybody, I'm drunk! Woo! Come on, we're off already. Jeez, fine, I'll rest. Resting gets rid of most temporary ailments like that. I'm still confused. God damn it. Would you freaking wear off? Christ. The exit down was over there, but we haven't completely explored this level yet. Okay, good. Looks like it wore off. Let's see. Where haven't we been? Pretty much just those two doors over on the right, it looks like. It shouldn't take too long for me to get there. I don't feel confused anymore. God, what a lightweight. One freaking potion and he's stumbling around like a, something that stumbles a lot. A stumbleweed. It's the cousin of the common tumbleweed. But it doesn't tumble, it stumbles. Rock? Oh yeah, I've been here. Forget you, Rock. Although, believe it or not, rocks are actually useful if you do decide to use a flail. Because that's your ammunition. Okay, we need to whip out our frost key. Absolutely nothing. Okay, just one more door to go in. In the court of the Crimson Key. And nothing. You know, I'm not really sure if monsters respawn in this game. I mean, it seems like they do. That zombie shouldn't have been there since I've already been in this room. If monsters do respawn, then that means the game, it's a lot harder to get stuck in the game. Because you can always just, yeah. I mean, they have to respawn. Those monsters definitely weren't there before. But, yeah, I mean, if you get stuck, you can always just walk around and fight some monsters and level up. If I do end up having to do that, though, I won't do it on camera. If I end up having to grind, because I know how tedious that is to watch. God, my direction sense is terrible. Is this the right way? I think so. Yeah. I'll find my way eventually, folks. I don't know, maybe they don't respawn. There's not a ton of monsters up here. I don't know. Hopefully, it won't make that much of a difference. Alright. And here we are, level 3. Level 3 of 18. I forgot to mention on the camp screen down here, it says your current level and how many levels there are in the dungeon. And this is the dungeon seed. If I gave you that number and you plugged it into this game, then you would end up playing the exact same dungeon that I am. Plume. That's a key. Whoa! I wonder if these guys are undead. I guess they don't count as undead. I'm not sure what exactly they are. Whoa! Holy crap! Some sort of acid-spitting monstrosity. Come on. What was that thing? Creature totems. It was a sheet ghoul. I think those are undead. Next time I run into one, I'll try turning it. I mean, ghoul sounds like an undead creature, don't you think? Ruby. Flee! And we are just about out of time again, so I'll go ahead and rest here. Save my game. And I'll see you next time on Let's Play Dungeon Hack. I'm Duke of the Bum. Good night, everybody.